Hello, I'm Mark Price. I'd like to talk to you today about four kinds of people. There was a drunk one night, late at night, and he was in a big parking lot. He was out searching the parking lot looking for his keys. And this man came along and saw him and asked what was wrong. And the fellow said, "I lost my keys." And he says, "Well, let me help you." And he's helping him, and they're half hour more, 30, 40 minutes, they're looking, searching for the keys. Finally, the man said to the drunk, he says, "Are you sure you lost them here?" And the drunk says, "No, I lost them over there, but the light's better here." See, sometimes we just don't know where to look, or we choose not to look in the right place. The gospel today is from Matthew chapter 13, verses 44 to 46. Jesus said to his disciples, "The kingdom of heaven is like a treasure buried in a field, which a person finds and hides again, and out of joy goes and sells all that he has and buys that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant searching for fine pearls. When he finds a pearl of great price, he goes and sells all that he has and buys it." The Gospel of the Lord. So here we have Jesus talking to his disciples about the kingdom of heaven, and it's knowing its value and what we should be willing to do for it. Here in both of these stories of the man who accidentally finds it in the field, he realizes the value, and so he hides it again and then goes and sells everything he has to buy that piece of land so that he could then have this thing of great value, the kingdom of heaven. And in this, the second reading, the reading of the pearl merchant, man who's in search of pearls and finds one and knows the value because it's his business and sells everything he has to come and be able to buy that one pearl, again, because he knew and understood the value. The things that are the same in these two parables is that in both cases, they understood the value and they were willing to sell everything they had to attain it. The difference in the two is the man who finds it in the lot, he found it by chance. He was out in the field and it was by chance that he found it, accidentally perhaps. But the pearl was discovered by a man who was searching. So I wanted to say that there are four kinds of people in our world today when it comes to the kingdom of God. The first one is the one who is searching for it and finds it like the pearl merchant. And he finds this pearl, this find. It's like people who go to auction houses or they in people's yards, they have yard sales and they pull over and they stop and they see something that they understand and know the value of, but no one else knew the value of. And so because they knew the value, they were willing to pay any price for it. And the second type of person, the first type of person is a person who is searching for the kingdom of God and finds it and understands the value and is willing to give everything that they have. The second is the person who finds it by chance. The man who discovers the treasure in the field, reburies it, and then because he understands the value, sells everything he has to get the field. That's the second type of person. The first is the one who's searching. The second is the one who finds it by chance. But in both cases, they know the value. The third person is the one who has it already, but doesn't realize it, doesn't understand or doesn't know the value of it. There was a story of a man in the late 1800s in South Africa, and they were just discovering gold in South Africa. And this man decided he wanted to find his fame and fortune by discovering gold. So he went and he sold everything he had, and he bought an acre of land, he bought himself a donkey, he bought himself pans, he bought himself hammers and chisels, everything he would need to go looking for gold. And the story is that he spent the rest of his life searching for gold, and he never really found it. And he died a very poor man. Later, when his lot was sold, his acre of ground was sold to somebody else, somebody came in and bought it, they discovered diamonds on that acre of land, And the diamond field, that acre, turned out to be the richest diamond field in South Africa's history up to that point. So here's a man who had the riches. He had, in essence, what he was really searching for, which was fame and riches. He had it, but he didn't realize it. His mind would not allow him to think that it could be there. When he was so focused on one thing, gold, he did not allow himself to see the riches that existed beyond gold. And there are many people in our world who are like this, who have it, who have this concept, this idea of the kingdom of heaven, who have the relationship that was established when they were perhaps young as a child, and don't realize really how it is, do not realize totally what they have. And so consequently, they go to their end of their life not realizing the happiness that was always right there, the kingdom of heaven that was always right there, because they just didn't open their mind and their heart to realize it. And the fourth kind of a person is the person who has it, but is not satisfied. It's the person who knows that what they have is right. They were taught it when they were kids. They were introduced to it throughout their lives. And they know the importance of the kingdom of God. They know the importance of what the kingdom of God is and represents and how it impacts our eternal life and where we end up being. But we're never satisfied. We're always looking for it somewhere else. We're always looking for the greener pasture. We're always looking for the greener grass. And I want to suggest to you that it's the world that does that. It's the evil in the world that tries to sow into our minds indecision. It tries to sow into us a discomfort with what we have, and this concept of, I better keep looking. Let me look elsewhere. Let me look over here. Let me look over there. There's an old saying that is kind of funny. It's when you find something, a guy lost the keys, he's looking for them and he finds them. And somebody asks, where did you find them? And he says, well, it was in the last place I looked. Well, of course it's in the last place you looked, because who finds something and then keeps looking? And I used to say to myself, that's a dumb thing. Of course, it's always in the last. But for some people, it's not. Some people, they find it, they have it, and yet it's not good enough. That world speaks to them and says, you can do better. You can go find elsewhere. Go find another faith, go find another religion, go turn in a different direction. Many people have this indecision when it comes to faith, because all of us who are people of faith, we have ups and downs in our faith. We have moments and times when the faith, we feel we're right there with God through Christ, and other times when we feel distant, we feel dissatisfied. And it's the world, it's the devil that plays on that. The Saint John of the Cross wrote a wonderful book called The Dark Night of the Soul that talks about that, those highs and lows, those ebbs and flows in our faith. And the world looks for any kind of high, low, up, down to work at us, to play on us, to send us in a different direction than the direction we know in our heart we should be following. By the way, this is also why, and one of the reasons, marriages and relationships dissolve or don't go anywhere after a time, because one or both of the partners aren't satisfied with what they have. They have something wonderful and great that drew them together, and yet they always feel that there's something better. They can do better. This isn't right for me. I can do 1,000 times better than this, or I can move in a different direction. And it's the world that does that. The world sees indecision in us, whether it's about faith or relationships, and it plays on that. It sows more dissatisfaction. It's like the dam that has a crack in it, and the pressure of the water is going to make that crack bigger and bigger until eventually the dam bursts. And relationships are like that. If we have any of the slightest indecision, the world, the evil in the world, works on us to make it a bigger and bigger and bigger crack until we move on, until the relationship is destroyed, until the marriage is destroyed. That's what the world does to us. And God, the world of God, the kingdom of God, is the thing that we should embrace, the thing that we should know is real, and we should trust God and not the world to move us in the right direction. So the four kinds of people, the people who are searching and find, the people who just come across it by chance, and in both cases willing to sell everything they have for this great find, this pearl of great price, this kingdom of heaven. The third is the somebody who has it but doesn't realize they have it. And the fourth is the person who has it but isn't satisfied. There's always got to be something better. And here's the question I have for you. Which kind of person are you? Of those four, where are you in your walk of faith? Amen? This is Mark Price. Thanks for listening.